In this video, we're gonna check a pack for Final Cut Pro that has a lot of different options when you want to create social media, like, subscribe, you want to have messages to show for your videos, you want to have mockups of mobile devices, you want to have enough of emojis or likes, you want to show a video that it's like Instagram Live or YouTube Live, a pack that has a lot of different stuff. Everybody, and welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are watching me for your first time, I'm Emilio and I post videos for tutorials on video editing, gear reviews, tech reviews, and so much more. In this video, we're gonna take a look on the FCPX Social Mega Pack, a pack from Pixel Film Studios that has a lot of different options and a lot of different things for you to choose. I'm gonna analyze all of them, or most of them, on the video here, because if I was gonna analyze all of it, it would take 2 hours. And if you're interested to get this pack, I will have a coupon code in the description of this video down below, and it's also popping up here. It's gonna be Emilio Pixel. I'm not gonna tell you the percentage of the discount. I'm gonna let you find out yourself. The FCPX Social Mega Pack, as soon as you download and install it, you're gonna find it here on the titles. Also, you're gonna find an element on the generators, but we're gonna see that later on this video. As we start, we can see that we have a lot of different elements, like the brightness and the volume change for your screen. You can have all the social media icons like the Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, YouTube. As you can see, a lot of things that we normally see in social mega packs. Let's imagine now that you want to place an emoji and you have your face right now and you're talking and you're moving left, right, and you want to track that emoji with Final Cut Pro, the updates with the tracking. You can simply drag the emoji, track the objects that you want to track, and then it will follow the emoji along your face. To check this out in action, as you can see here on the emojis that they are animated emojis as well, I can take, for example, the silly face. I can drag it, place it on my face, automatically is gonna start the process to analyze for the tracker. As you can see here also, I have a title generated, and I will click right to analyze the movement. I will click done, and I go here on the inspector panel on the right. I will take this, place it here on my face, and as you can see, I'm gonna change the overall scale. Simply as that, I have an emoji that it's trackable on the screen. Moving on, we have follow screens for Facebook, all the social media, icon emitters, and if I roll over, you can see what you can expect from that, a lot of different options. And then we go to the live comments and the live section. For example, we grab this and place it into the timeline. And as you can see here, we go into the inspector panel. We will select for the drop zone the clip that we want. We can select the clip from the library, of course, so you go here, you select the clip that you want to use, and the only thing to remember is to bring the audio of the clip as well. And you have a YouTube Live interface that also you can place YouTube Live comments as well, and you can place them on the right spot here to appear. Also, you have Facebook Live interface, you have Instagram Live, you have TikTok Live, all of the different interfaces, and of course the reactions as well. You can have live reactions for your videos as well, that again you just drag and place them, or a live interface, the burst of the likes and the hearts and the emojis. You have lower thirds options, and let's go now and check how you can have the messages that you saw in the beginning. On the messages section, you have a lot of different kind of composing, send and receive, group or images, but also you have reactions for the messages as well. And then you have a message chain. That's a little bit easier because you don't have to track and you don't have to place the messages into the correct position. For example, let's say that we have 4 messages chain. I'm gonna drag this, place it here, and then I can go to the inspector panel and enter the messages. For example, one message that I'm can send is, hey, have you checked out FCPX social megapack. The second message can be, oh, no. Is that good? Yeah, it's straight fire. Great. I'm taking it now. And as you can see, it starts all the messages that you want to have. Now, on the inspector panel, of course, in order to make it look a little bit better, you will see because I have more lines, I can go to the height of the first message and raise it here in the inspector panel. Also, I can change the delay in seconds. For example, I can wait 3 seconds for the one, 4 seconds for the third, and 4 seconds for the other one. And making adjustments on the seconds so we don't get confused with all the different messages. And then I can drag this, place it here, for example, and I have the sequence that we saw in the beginning. As we move on, we can see that we have different profiles, options to choose for our videos, social media graphics, for like, subscribe, subscribe buttons, for example, or Instagram likes, Facebook post interface, and different social media post examples. For example, we can post an Instagram post or we can post a Twitter post for our videos, all animated, different tags that we can have, type writer tools, channel tools, for example, click notification, the bell notification ring, the like, the YouTube, subscribe, share, everything, everything you need in one pack. Video creator tools with different buttons, cursors, dragging media, open hand, close hands, and at the end we have end screens, very simple, for example, drag, place, and you have an end screen ready to have on your videos. As with all the plugins from Pixel Film Studios, it gets recent updates. That means that you pay once and you get a lot of updates that they're updating the content and you get more options, more effects, or more things to do with the pack that you already have. Something very interesting that I mentioned in the beginning is the option to have different elements under the generator files. Not on the titles on top, but the generators. As you can see, we have 3D icons for a lot of different services and applications. For example, Amazon, Android, apps, we can have the bell, and social media logos, profiles, etc. Also, we can have an interface for a 3D laptop, and the process to use that is, again, very simple, and you can see that you can have different lighting options, like a softbox or a simple light, a field, different options for the lighting as well, and you just drag this, place it here, and then you go in the inspector panel, you can adjust all the different settings for the styling and the drop zone again, as you saw before how we can change the screen media and the drop zones. And lastly, you can have 3D phones. For example, you can take, let's see, a 12 Pro Max. We would love to see new models as well. On the spotlight, you bring that, you place it here. You can also have a screen media template that you can use for that, or a camera flash. You go into the inspector panel on the right, you can adjust a lot of different things like the time or what metal you want the phone to be, the colors and everything like that. You go to the screen media controls and then you click on the source. Again, you're gonna click, I'm gonna go to the library, I'm gonna select this project, apply clip, and then you can make animation with the transform controls or the camera controls at the bottom. For example, you can start and have a rotation, let's say here, add the keyframe, move a little bit and make it 0%. You can go again to the beginning and you can go to transform controls and add a keyframe to the overall scale to make it bigger as we move forward. And as we move forward, we can make it bigger. And also we can adjust the X, Y, and Z position. And then we can go again to the camera controls and we can make rotations on all the X, Y, and Z axes. That means that we can add a keyframe here, and as we move forward, we can change the rotation to the Y, and it's gonna animate to the right as well. And then here again, I can add a keyframe to the X and make it a little bit like that, as you can see. And I can change the settings on the depth, how depth of field blur I want to have, far focus, different filters on defocus, size, filter shape, a lot of things that you can play. Just remember to have a lot of power when you want to create this kind of effects, because it's gonna need a lot of power from your computer. But with the new M1 chips, come on, we can handle everything, right? And as soon as we finish, we click on the edit mode so we can have the video appear as well. And you can see something like that. Pixel Film Studios also has a YouTube channel where they have tutorials on how to use Final Cut Pro. From beginners to advanced, a lot of features and things to do. Go check them out. I will have a link in the description of this video down below as well for that. I hope you found this video and this pack helpful. And if you did, don't forget to do all this great, amazing YouTube stuff. Like this video if you have any questions. I'm waiting you as always in the comment section down below. Thank you so much to Pixel Film Studios for supporting this channel. Thank you for watching. I'm Emilio, and I will see you in the next video.